The White House has taken a measured response to Israel's attack on an aid flotilla bound for Gaza. It wasn't an attack. It was they boarded the ship and it ended up being a confrontation. They were going along, is the U.S. going along with a U.N. resolution calling for an investigation? But this isn't the first time this White House has held Israel on the outs. Are they trying to distance themselves from our ally?
Joining us now, New York Congressman Peter King. He has sent a letter out to his colleagues urging them to join him on a resolution in support of Israel. Good morning to you, Congressman.
Good morning, Gretchen.
All right, so let's look at the bullet points of this letter that you have sent out to your colleagues. You're calling on legislation for this, the U.S. to resign from the U.N. Human Rights Council. Why?
The U.N. Human Rights Council, first of all, President Bush refused to join it. President Obama joined it last year, hoping it would somehow win over the other side. This is a charade. This is a group that has countries on, like Cuba and Nicaragua. Several years ago, Libya was the chair of the Human Rights Council. They voted to condemn Israel. I think it was 33-3 last week. This is strictly a pro-third world, anti-American council. It's hypocritical. It never condemns what's done against Israel. It only condemns Israel. And by us being on it, we're giving it a respectability it doesn't deserve. And we should just pull ourselves out of it, make it clear we have nothing to do with it.
The U.N. General Secretary came out and said, hey, we want the U.S.'s support for a general investigation into what happened with that flotilla where it went down and people lost their lives and a bunch of special forces Israelis were wounded. What's wrong with an inquiry using the U.N. as a body?
First of all, I don't believe the U.N. is qualified because there's such a bias against Israel, and it's very much a pro-third world bias they have. But in addition to that, well, by having this investigation, we're almost setting up a moral equivalency between Israel and Hamas. The fact is, Israel is under siege. Israel has had thousands of missiles coming into it from Gaza. Their blockade is entirely justified by international law. It's self-defense.
Right.
And this would be as if we allowed the U.N. to investigate the U.S. when we blockaded Cuba in 1962. By setting up the investigation where, in fact, saying that Israel could be wrong, that this blockade might be wrong, when we should, as an ally, should be saying this blockade is absolutely right. We're not going to be part of any investigation about it. And that's why I'm saying that no U.S. taxpayer dollar, not $1, should be used to encourage this investigation or be part of this investigation.
Right. That's point two of your legislation that you're going to introduce. You also want to express that the U.S. stands with the Israeli people, express support for Israeli self-defense, express support for the Israel blockade. But let me ask you this. Netanyahu, the prime minister of Israel, was supposed to meet with the president before this whole thing unfolded. Do you have any hope that the two of them are going to get together?
I would hope so, because since President Obama came to office, he's been distancing himself from Israel. One is by saying there's an equivalency between Iranian nuclear weapons and Israeli construction in Jerusalem, the way he treated Prime Minister Netanyahu back in March and April of this year. He is distancing himself from Israel. I would hope that he would realize that in the Middle East, Israel is our closest ally.
Right.
It's the only democracy in the Middle East. And
gotcha.
Why he's backing away from Israel, it's just, to me, another apology.
Congressman King, always great. Thanks.
Thank you, Brian.
All right, coming up straight ahead.
A woman.